And welcome to another video. So today we are going to show you how to download and set up Hik-Connect, which is the app from Hikvision, which allows you to remotely view your CCTV as well as many other features which I'm going to go through for your CCTV DVR or NVR. Okay, so this is your phone app. This is available for Android and Apple, and I'm going to run through the whole set, the whole configuration from download to sharing the app, everything in between. Is going to be on this little guide for you. Okay, so what am I covering? Okay then, so first of all, the first thing we're going to do is download the app. Okay, I'm going to show you where to go to download the links for, like I said, Android and Apple, and then we're going to go ahead and install the app. Remember to turn off your Wi-Fi beforehand, and then I'm going to show you how to create an account, and then we're going to enable Hik-Connect on our DVR NVR, and then we're going to add the device to our app. And then we should be able to view live. I'm going to show you how to view the playback and share the app. Okay, hopefully now you should be able to get the CCTV on your phone, no problem. And if you don't forget to subscribe and leave any comments below if you have anything, and enjoy the video. Thank you. Hey guys, and what we're going to do now is go ahead and download the app. So the website you type in is appstore.hikvision.com. Okay, so you go here and we can download Hik-Connect app. You see there's two, one's for installer, but most of you guys are going to want for end user, so go ahead and click on download. Okay, so that's going to download the app. You want to download? Yes, please. Click on download. Okay, so it's downloading the file now. So if you do use Apple, this is for Android, but if you do use Apple, I'm going to put a link below for the App Store for Apple, and I'll put a link below as well for Android. But it's going to go ahead and let that download. But remember guys, as soon as you've downloaded the file, remember to turn your Wi-Fi off. I'll remind you again in a bit. It's fine to download in the app, but once we've set it all up, then we can go ahead and use our Wi-Fi again. So just remember, download the app with your Wi-Fi, turn your Wi-Fi off, follow the rest of the instructions using your data, and then once it's all set up, then you can go ahead and use your Wi-Fi again, no problems, okay? So we're gonna go ahead and let that download. Okay, so it's downloaded, so you go ahead and click open. So we want to install the app, yes. Install. Okay, so we go done. All right then, so what we're gonna do is, remember guys, there we go, Hik-Connect app has been added. What we're gonna do now is go ahead and turn our Wi-Fi off, and then we're gonna go ahead and set up Hik-Connect. So we turn off our Wi-Fi and let's go ahead and open up Hik-Connect. Okay, so we've opened up Hik-Connect. Remember guys to turn your Wi-Fi off, make sure it's off for this process, and we're going to go ahead and agree. Okay, so we're going to select the region. It's already found United Kingdom, but if you're not sure, you can just search up here. Okay, select your country and then click on the tick. Okay, so we select United Kingdom, we go okay. All right then. So what we're going to do is click on login register, and we're going to create an account. If you just don't want to do a quick setup for some reason, you can set visitor mode, but it's highly recommended that you create an account with your email address. So on the left here, we can click on register. Okay, join us, agree. Select your region again, okay, United Kingdom. And you put in your password, you put in your email and create a password. Okay, so. Okay, and we create a password. We can just call this Hikvision 123. Okay, all right then. So we go to get security code. Oh, the password should contain at least 3 character types. Okay, so we do. Next, we could do capital H. Hikvision 123. Okay, we go get a security code. Okay, so you check your email and you get your code. Okay then, so I'm going to enter my code and I receive an email. Okay then, so now we are logged in, we've created an account, and that's how you do it. So we really recommend here now that when you set your account password, please don't forget it, okay? It's very important that you don't forget it. Once you've got this account, you can log into any Hik-Connect account and be able to get all your devices that we're going to add in a second. Okay, so that's what we're going to do right now is add some devices. Okay then, so now we're going to go ahead and add a device, which is your DVR, NVR or IP camera. Okay then, so to add the device, we click on the plus at the top right hand corner. Okay, so click on that plus. And I'm going to show you two ways to add the device. One is going to be to scan the QR code, and the other one is going to be manual adding. So manual adding basically means you just put the serial number in and it will find it. Okay, but right now we're going to do scan QR code. Okay, so what I'm going to quickly do is flip over to our DVR and show you exactly where to go to find the QR code and all the settings you need to set up on the DVR so this is going to work. Okay. I'll flip over now and then we'll come back here and scan the QR code. Okay, see you guys in a sec. Okay then, so we're over now to our DVR and what we're going to do is make sure Hik-Connect is enabled, set our verification code, and then we'll show you where the QR code is. Okay, so on the top right hand corner here you have a system icon. It's a bit like a cog, so you click on that system icon, and then on the left here we have network. Then under network we have advanced, and then eventually we get to platform access. Okay then, so sometimes it's in a different place, but it's always under network. So what you're looking for is platform access. Okay then, access type Hik-Connect. Perfect, it's already there. So you click on enable, and then click on the other tick box. Okay, all right then, and then we're gonna put in a verification code. Okay then, so this is really anything you can put in here. You're just gonna ask you for it later on the app just to make sure that you know what's going on. So I'm just going to choose 123456. All right then, unlinked, that means that has no account associated with it. Okay, my DVR is saying offline at the moment, but I'm sure it's just a temporary thing. Yeah, okay, so it says online, we have Hik-Connect enabled, and you see here now we have two QR codes. The one on the left is the one we're going to use to scan when it asks us to scan to scan the code, okay, through the app. And the other one is for the app itself, but you need a QR code reader for that. But I've already told you where to go to download the app, so you can use this one, but we're going to look at the left hand side one here. And now I'm going to flip back to the phone and show you how to scan the QR code and add the device to Hik-Connect. See you guys in a sec. Okay, so we're back to our phone view, and we're going to go ahead and click on the plus icon on the top right hand corner. And we're going to go click on scan QR code. Okay then, so we allow the phone and we're going to go ahead and scan that left hand side QR code that we found in the DVR. Okay, it's found it already. And then we're going to add that device it's found. Okay, adding complete, good. So we go to next, we save that. Okay, to do with the phone. Okay, so we've added the device, and you can see now it's on here on the main screen. So we've got a couple of buttons here, but what we're going to do is actually click on the DVR itself, and then here we can look at the live view, and I can show you a few of the live view features. Okay, I'll see you there in 2 seconds. Okay, I just showed you how to add the device through a QR code, and now we're going to add the device through serial number. Okay, so we click on the plus icon at the top right hand corner, and we're going to go manual adding. Okay then, so what you need is your serial number for your device. Okay, it can be found on the box that it came in or underneath your DVR. It's usually found there. So I have mine, and I'm going to go ahead and enter in the serial number. Okay, then you click on save at the top right hand corner. Okay, so it's found the device. Okay, and this is the verification code that we would have entered when we set up our device on the DVR. So if you remember, that was 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay. And if you forgot that device, go to your DVR platform access, which is under Network Advanced. Okay. Or just check the video out. All right, so we save that. And that's added our device. As you can see there, the DVR is there. And now we're gonna go ahead and click on the DVR and go to the live view, and I'm gonna show you a few features there. Okay. Okay then, so we've now downloaded Hik-Connect, installed Hik-Connect. We've added devices, set up an account, and we're all ready now to go view live. So to view live, simply just literally click on the physical DVR itself, and it's going to bring up all your live cameras. Okay, so there's our live cameras. Okay, we're going to look at camera one right now. So click on camera one, and we're going to click on this one button here. So we're just going to bring this up a bit bigger. Okay, so one here brings up one screen. Okay, you can obviously click on the four here and just have four screens. We're just going to work with the one for now, because it's easier. Okay, so as you see, there's a few icons here. Let's go through the icons and I'll explain to you what those do. So the first one, we'll take a snapshot. Okay, so you could take a snapshot and it'll save it to your phone. Second one, we'll record the video onto your phone. Okay, so it'll be the selected camera you've chosen here. This is the microphone. Our camera hasn't got microphone built in. But if you have a microphone or two-way audio, you can talk through the camera here. But this one hasn't got that capability. We've got many videos and two-way audio if you're interested in it. And this is the last icon, is the microphone. So you can, if you have an audio camera, you can turn the audio on and off through that. Okay, we have a few buttons at the bottom too. So where it says basic, this is quite an important button. That means you're basically getting a substream that is coming through to your app. So if you want to go full stream, get HD picture, we go HD here, and now we turn our picture HD. Okay, you can't see much difference on this one, but I'm telling you, HD is a lot clearer picture. Okay, but we will use more bandwidth than your phone, so do be careful. Okay, and then the second icon here, we got the zoom, so we can zoom in. Okay, and the third icon here is for PTZ control. So if you have a pan tilt zoom camera, one that rotates and moves, you can control it here through the app and zoom your camera around. Okay, we don't have one here right now, but it's very easy to control through the phone, and that's that. And there's a couple more other ones here, but they really don't do that much, so we're gonna leave this for now. Okay, so that's your live view, how to do your basic settings. Now we're gonna go back to the main view, and I'm gonna show you how to get playback and view your old stored playback. Okay, via the app. Okay, so I'm now going to show you how to view the playback via your Hik-Connect app on your phone. So to click on the device, just click on the DVR picture and it brings up the live view. So at the top right hand corner, we have three dots, click there, and it brings up a little menu, and the first one's playback. So we click on playback. Okay, so we have our camera one here plugged in. All right, so as you see already, we're in playback mode. We can scroll down here and view our playback. Okay, so from here you can control the date. So you select your date of the playback, and this is your time scale here. You got all the times here, and there you go. So you can record your playback, view your playback. Let me see me coming into work. It should be about 9 o'clock. Okay, maybe I was late that day. Any joking? There we are. Okay, so that's the playback working. And if you want to take a snapshot here, you can just go take a quick snapshot of your playback, or you can set record, and it will start recording your recorded playback. Obviously, we've got videos on how to take the footage off your DVR. And that's basically the main features of the playback. Obviously, here you can turn your audio off, you can zoom in, just basic stuff, but. There's your basic guide to playback through Hik-Connect. Okay, so now I'm going to show you guys how to share the app. Okay, there's a couple of different ways of doing this. The first way is the easy way, but you have to pass over your details. So you put in your Hik-Connect login details, and you can give that to someone. But obviously you can only give this to people you trust, okay, because they'll have control over your device. But if you wanted to give it to a member of staff, something like that, I'm going to show you how to do that. Okay. So next to Well, it says my device and the number, the serial number, the model number. Click on the three dots. So that three dot icon. Okay. And then we click on share with user. All right then. So one way to share with the user is to share via the QR code. So here we'll generate a QR code, and then the person you're going to share it with, make sure they have Hik-Connect downloaded. And then, as I showed you how to scan a QR code, so to use the same method of add device, scan QR code, and then they can scan this QR code phone to phone. Okay, but I'm not going to show you that method now, but I've explained it. I'm going to do share via email. Okay, then. So we put in the email address of the person you want to share with. Okay, obviously make sure they have Hik-Connect downloaded. Okay, share Hik-Connect. Okay, so then we go yes. Okay, then it says here, history recipient. Click on that. Oh, no, it's now clicked. See, it's ticked blue. We go next at the bottom. Okay, so these are all the cameras you can share with the recipient. So for example, we have some IP cameras on the system. We don't want them to have access to the IP cameras. So I'm just gonna withdraw that access and then we go next. Okay, and then here's more about the permissions, exactly what they can do. We're just gonna give them all that permission though and just go finish. Okay, so now I've shared the device with someone else. Okay, so you heard that bib bib. That means I've received a notification on my Hik-Connect app that someone wants to share. Okay then, so I'm gonna go now ahead and access and accept that. Okay then, so that device has now been shared, and that pretty much sums up our little video on Hik-Connect app. So I hope you guys have managed to get the app now running on your phone. Everything's all smooth and running nicely. I'll just quickly show you another couple of menus. For example, below here you have notifications. So if you do set motion detection up on your system, or you have an intercom, this is where you're going to get your missed calls or your motion detection alerts. Okay, then under more here, there's a few extra settings. This, for example, the pictures and videos you've saved on the app, you can view here. Okay, and there's not many interesting things here. But if you did have various accounts, you can log out, for example. But we're going to go back to the main view and click on the hexagon. Okay, so here you can turn notifications off for some reason. Maybe you're on a busy meeting or you're getting a lot of false notifications and you want to turn it off. You can just go there. And if you want to delete the device as well, you can. This is where you can delete the device. Okay, so it will unbind it from the DVR. You'll no longer have access to it, and you'll have to set it up all again. Okay, so there's your basic rundown of Hik-Connect. I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and yeah, hopefully you're all on Hik-Connect now, no problems, and I'll see you on the next one. Cheers, thanks, bye.